natural selection does not provide any new genetic information. And for evolution,
there has to be a new genetic
information. We need new genetic information.
And where does the new genetic information going to come from?
Well, that's the big question. Darwin assumed that the increase in information comes from natural selection. But natural selection reduces genetic information. And we know this from all the genetic population studies that we have. Generally, we are afraid of mutations. We don't want to have too many X-rays. We don't want to have Chernobyl. We don't want to have mutagenic substances like asbestos around us, whatever. Right. So we are avoiding mutations because we know that mutations spoil. We do not know of any mutation which is positive.
So you're saying that the idea that there could be random mutations caused by ultraviolet lights or radiation or some extreme of temperature that would create a new species is simply unknown.
Well, that has never been observed.
It has never been
observed. We have never observed a change, a genetic change by mutation, which produced something new and positive.
So, but if that's true, then Darwinism collapses.
Exactly.
When we look at any kind of system that we've made that has some of these properties, then we say, well, we're just going to throw in a random variation. What happens to the system? You try that on a computer.
What does happen?
You just take your program, you take Windows and say, well, I'm going to press a smudged finger here, there, and everywhere, change the program a little bit. It should, because the thing just collapses. It just doesn't function. There has to be a very powerful...
Oh, this is very good. So that, for example, if you analogize a computer program to the DNA inside a cell, you can't just change it, it would just stop working.
It not only stops working, it crashes immediately. Unless you put tons of specially designed protection into the system that can handle random changes. But if you do that, and the cell has that kind of stuff, then the whole idea that the driving force of evolution is a random change, that loses a lot of its plausibility.